guess I'm going to walk. Oh, that milky white way. Oh, child, some of these days. Well, I'm going to walk that milky white way. Oh, some of these days. Well, 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 I'm going to walk up and take up my stand. Gonna join that Christian band. I'm going to walk, whoa, that milky white way. Oh Lord, some of these days I'm gonna tell my, oh, my mother, howdy, 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 when I get home. Yes, I'm going to tell my mother howdy when I get home. Well, 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 I want to tell my mother hey when I shake mother hand that day. That's when I won't. Oh, that milky white way. Some of these days. I want to meet God the Father and God the Son. Yes, I want to meet God the Father. God the Son. Well, well,
he brings grief, he will show compassion. So great is his unfailing love. He will swallow up death forever. Then the Lord God will wipe away the tears from all faces. Our God is our strength, our comfort, our peace. He will shield us. Show compassion, so great is his unfailing love. For God so loved the world that he gave his only son so that everyone who believes in him may not perish but have eternal life. I tell you the truth, if anyone keeps my word, he would never see death. So it will be with the resurrection of the dead. The body that is sown is perishable. It is raised imperishable. It is sown in dishonor. It is raised in glory. It is sown in weakness. It is raised in power. It is sown a natural body. It is raised a spiritual body. Thank you, God, for being our peace, God. Thank you, God, for being our comforter. be with the resurrection of the dead. The body that is sown is perishable. It is raised imperishable. It is sown in dishonor. It is raised in glory. It is sown in weakness. It is raised in power. It is sown a natural body. It is raised a spiritual body. But God will redeem my life from the grave. He will surely take me to himself. I tell you the truth. A time is coming and has now come when the dead will hear the voice of the Son of God, and those who hear will live. For this God is our God forever and ever. He will be our God even until death. He will swallow up death forever. Then the Lord God will wipe away the tears from all faces. Whoever hears my word and believes him who sent me has eternal life and will not be condemned. He has crossed over from death to life. Do not be discouraged, for the Lord your God will be with you wherever you go. Do not be discouraged, for the Lord your God will be with you wherever you go. For since death came through a man, the resurrection of the dead comes also through a man. For as in Adam all die, God. keeping us. Thank you, God, for strengthening us. Thank you, God, for your comfort. Lord, we need you. We're nothing without you, God. He will wipe every tear from their eyes. There will be no more death, or mourning, or crying, or pain. For the old order of things has passed away. Though he brings grief, he will show compassion. So great is his unfailing love. He will swallow up death forever. Then the Lord God will wipe away the tears from all faces. Jesus said to her, I am the resurrection and the life. Those who believe in me, even though they die, will live. And everyone who lives and believes in me would never die. For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him may not perish, but have eternal life.
Over from death to life. Do not
Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. For I am convinced that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor rulers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth,
broken hearted. And
the tears from all faces. I tell you the truth, whoever hears my word and believes him who sent me has eternal life and will not be condemned. He has crossed over from death to life.
Has called me haven't witnessed the count day yet. Say yes, Lord. Can I get everybody to say yes, Lord?
Lord God, we ask Him, God, that You just hold them in the hollow of Your own hand. Oh God, in the name of Jesus, rock them tonight, Lord. Let them know you have not left them alone, oh God. But right now, God, as they go through the pain, we just ask for you for the comfort. For the comfort right now, God. And we thank you, Lord God. We bless you, Father. We bless you, Father. We bless you, Father, because you will not leave us, not with you. Oh, God. Oh, God, not will you forsake us. So bless, God, all around this room, all the family members that's around this room, Lord God. We ask that you just hold them in the hollow of your hand. And, God, we just know that it's going to get better. At your time, Lord God. At your season, Lord God. So, Father God, again, I ask that you just bless the family, comfort them tonight, oh God, as they shed their tears. Those tears are going to be shed. But God, just hold them in the heart of your own hand. In Jesus' name, we do pray.
Thank you, Dr. Jackson. At this time, I will read an Old Testament scripture. It comes from Isaiah chapter 43 and verse 2. I will be reading a New Living Translation. When you go through deep waters, I will be with you. When you go through rivers of difficulty, you will not drown. When you walk through the fire of oppression, you will not be burned up. The flames will not consume you. Family, friends, and loved ones, you can be encouraged because God will be with you on your good days, bad days, and darkest hours. No matter what your situation or circumstances are, God will always be with you. You may feel overwhelmed, but God will not allow this to consume you. You may feel like you're sinking, but trust him. Keep your faith and hope alive. In the midst of everything that we're going through, God is still God. Jesus is your life vest when you're in troubled waters. He will not let you drown. He will not let you drown. Love you and God bless you. At this time, we're going to have our New Testament scripture from Reverend Shannon Tillett.
Good evening. I'm giving honor to God, our Lord and Savior, and Jesus Christ. I'm giving honor to this bereaved family and all the friends who came out for this celebration. Our scripture comes from 2 Timothy chapter 4. Verses 7 and 8. I have fought a good fight. I have finished my course. I have kept the faith. Henceforth, there is laid up for me a crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, shall give me that day, and not only to me, but unto them also that love is appearing. God bless the reader and the hearers of his word. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Reverend Sillett. At this time, we're gonna have a musical selection from Katerian Jones.
First thing, give honor to God, who was the head of my life and yours. I want to say thank you, God, for allowing me to be here and celebrate the season of life, not only with my OGP family at Walmart, but also the CJ family. I'm going to keep you in my prayers. Before I start saying, I want to say that CJ brought joy to us in that department. I mean, when he first came in, he said, what's up, CJ? I said, what's up, man? He said, yeah, man, my mom said if I stay 4 months, she gonna buy me a skirt. I said, well, CJ, I said, if it's the Lord's will, I hope you get that skirt. And hopefully God got that skirt when you open the gates for him. So, to his family, he gonna get that skirt. But if you know this song, join in with me. If not, just praise the Lord anyway.
We all gathered here in your presence, Lord, with our arms open wide. We lift the hands. We welcome you to abide. Oh Lord, we need your spirit. We need your spirit right now. Oh.
Oh! Get up here and give y'all a couple words of my father, Graham, my brother, who knows much about her God, CJ, the candy car, she was, and my dad. Growing up as a kid, it's tough for me because I used to be in the shed where I didn't like going outside at all, and still to this day, it was one person who never cared about what you were going through, or all you ever wanted was a friend from outside. But CJ never looked at anyone different because once you met him, he was a friend for life. There'd be times after CJ I run from my side, he used to tell my grandma and me and I'd be at the road playing on me that hit. When she went from out of the chair, that she'd have fun. I didn't know how fun I felt like until I met him. You know, CJ, as long as I knew him, you know he will always have something up his sleeve, make you laugh, smile, or even surprise you with something like your day. Never when you catch him weeping, never when you see him mad, every time you look at Wade, he's that strong, genuine, righteous, cool dude on the block that you can trust. Yeah, you're back, but today I got your back. The family is where I love you, baby boy. So that goes apart. That's the only way I will give you. Amen.
He came in laughing and lying. He was, I mean, every, I'm sorry.
kids used to be saying, more straight jet lines. And after a while, I'm like, okay, now straight jet, you're doing a little too much right now. It sound like you might be lying. But he always brought joy. We always laughed. I mean, I know God makes no mistakes, and I know we're not supposed to question, but I just don't understand, because he was such a good person. Like, everybody he came in contact with, he loved good, positive energy. Shane, I love you, baby. You know me and my kids. I can't think of your name. With the whole family, like, we're always here for y'all. Whenever y'all need us, we will keep street name alive. And Shay, I thank you for sharing him with me. You know I want to. And the Sunday night before his accident happened, I did get a chance to get a hug, and he told me, "Mom, too, I love you."
Appreciate what I gave you. You're going to take those memories and you're going to cherish them. You're going to continue to walk in his name, you and your family, and you guys will survive. He told me, he said, if I brought you to it, I'm going to see you through. This is not a test for me, but a test for everybody. My faith had to come from somewhere, and I still don't know where it's coming from. But I know it's coming. So, Lord, I turn your child back over to you, because I know he's in the best of hands. I've had a lot of raises through this time, and I'm probably going to have some more. But my son told me, he said, Mom, he took the best. So it took me back to the Father who is the Alpha and the Omega. And the Father deserved nothing but the best. So we give it to you, Lord. And I ask that you continue to take care of him and us too. But with that, I know we have an angel that I can call mine. With that, I'm going to walk away and say, CJ, I'll see you soon. Take care of my baby, Lord. I'm depending on you.
Gonna go home today. And I asked CJ all the time, I said, well, CJ, did you tell your mama you're down here? I told him, my mama know I'm down here. And I didn't believe him. I worked all the time, but my home was CJ home. Whenever something, I wasn't having a good day, my children brighten up my day. Every day. And I just hate that I lost him. But I know God gave the angel, and my grandson gave the guardian. And I just want to say, Shay, I love you. We love you. And we're going to miss you today.
CJ come around there. Grandma know he been in the house because he been there cutting a piece of the pound cake. So he out there gonna eat it with milk that just was him. Me, CJ, Romero, all of us, man, when we grew up, that was fun times. Like, it wasn't no negative energy. And like I said, CJ was just that person. Like, he did not have no ill feelings, no negative, nothing about CJ made you look at him like, bro, why am I around you? CJ was just one of those ones, and anytime you come around, you're gonna laugh. It ain't no path we didn't walk through, it ain't no shortcut. We used to be a clubhouse. New time, we are new time. We are new time. We did everything around there. Like, me and CJ, he helped bury my dog. That was like hard to do for me. I called him early in the morning. I'm like, cuz, I need you to come help. He come around there, he picked up the dog, he dropped the dog. He picked the dog back up, and he picked up the truck, we went out in the land, and we buried the dog in the back. But anything I called on CJ, you know, CJ was gonna be right there. I don't care if we had to ride somewhere, he was ready to ride. One night he said, cuz, I got $20, I'm gonna put it in the tank, we finna ride. You know what I'm talking about? We roll well, we could go off that $20. I just so much, but I ain't gonna say y'all that. But y'all, CJ, that was my boy. That was my best friend. I love him. And I love I love my family for allowing him to be a part of my life and allowing me to be a part of his life. We were just like this. We had lives in the game and everything.
Meet again. There will be no more lies. There will be no more crying over on the other side. Greetings in the name of God, our Creator, and to Jesus, our Savior, and to our hideous Luma, our blessed Holy Spirit, and to the prolific proclaimers of the gospel, greetings in the name of Jesus, and to the bereaved family. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy coming in the morning. And to all that thought it my robbery to come out, for this celebration of life for CJ. The eulogy has been well spent. Everyone that knew CJ, they knew that he was a comical guy. He would keep you laughing. And as they said, CJ might tell a little lie here and there. But you know that, Jim? CJ. And to my son and to Sharon, God is still in charge. No matter what it looked like around you, but God will continue to hold you in the hollow of his hand. God is a good God. Our scripture on today will be found in Philippians. Philippians chapter 2, verse 9. And it reads, therefore God also has highly exalted him and given him the name which is above every name.
Yes, sir.
And I'd like to talk from this subject. There is a name. There is a name. Father, thank you for all that you have done. Father, thank you for your son Jesus, Lord Christ, who all bled and died on yonder cross so that we would have a right to the tree of life. And Father, we thank you for being our great master.
Yes,
and Father, we thank you for loaning us CJ for these 21 years. Father God, there will be many memories that we can always reach back and think about something CJ done or what CJ has done. But Father, we just thank you for all these blessings, Father. And we thank you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
There is a name.
Yes, yes, yes.
Every one of us here today has been given a name. Most of us have a first name, middle name, and a last name. Our parents gave us the name we have for a reason. We may have the name of a family member, a loved one that has passed on. My family named me after my great-great-grandfather. His name was Ed English, so they named me Ed. Some of us have been given a nickname. Some nickname that we go by only our family knows domain. A nickname like Junebug, TT. But we have a nickname. A nickname that fit us for some reason or another. Some may be called my little Pooh Bear. But there are nicknames.
Some of us even have embarrassing nicknames. Don't call me that. I'm not a little child anymore. Don't call me that nickname anymore. We may not even know how we got that nickname. Somebody just started calling us that name and we just somehow got stuck with that nickname. Jacambion Jacari Street got stuck with the nickname CJ. Whatever your birth name may be. But I'm here to tell you there are reasons why you've been given your name. We look in the Bible, well, we see people that have names. Peter is called the Rock. And if we go back to the fresh fire book of Moses, we see where God changed Abel to Abraham. And Sarah to Sarah. God gave them a name for a specific reason. And each of us in here on today have our name for a specific reason. Whatever your birth name may be, it's for a significant reason. My mama had 10 kids. A lot of times she'll say, hey, you come here, girl, come here or go there. So many of us, she'd be forgetting who we are. But we all have a name. Names are powerful. And our names are significant to us. Our name is our identity. It is how we introduce ourselves. This is how we change our relationship with someone. When you first meet someone, you know that introduction, hi, my name is so-and-so. And they will return with giving their name. But names are very important to us. But I'm here today to declare to you that there is a name. A name that has more pull and more power than our name could ever have. At one point, we all in here were strangers. We didn't know anyone else outside of our family until we went to school and we met other little classmates. And our circle began to grow. Our name is what we answer to when someone calls our name. We respond, some of us have been called out of our name. The Lord has said, you've been called everything except a child of God. But I'm here to tell you today that no matter what someone may call you, tell them that I am a child of God. And if you don't believe me, just follow me down to the Jordan Street. See, my name on today is Redeemed. Because one day I decided to call on Jesus. As a child, I was coming up in church. I would hear them say that there is power in the name of Jesus. There is deliverance in that name of Jesus. And I said, if I call on that name and tell him that I need him to come in and be the Lord of my life. And it is saying that I will have eternal life. But as we segue into our sermonic text on today, our verse 9 will be our focal verse. We will find these words. Therefore, God also has highly exalted him and given him the name which is above every name, there is a name. This name is Jesus the Christ. He didn't have to look in a name book a common name for this name. But God himself said, this is what I want you to call my child. We go back 700 years prior to that. We will see what Isaiah said. His name shall be called Emmanuel. That is to say that God is with us. And this name of Jesus, every knee shall bow. And it say of those in heaven and those on earth. And of those under the earth. And that every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. To the glory of God the Father. Some may not want to acknowledge Jesus as being the Lord of Lords, not a King of Kings. But there's going to come a time when you won't have a choice. It's better to do it now before the fire comes. If you think you so stout-hearted that you're going to live here forever, you got another day coming. There are only two places for you, heaven or hell. You hear people say, how can a loving God that loves us so much put us in hell? Well, I'm here to tell you that God is not putting us in hell. Amen. My mama would always say, God didn't even want us to go to hell. He said that he would, that all would come unto repentance. But the Bible says hell is standing enlarging itself. So don't think that if you continue living any kind of way that by the time you get to hell, there will be no vacancy. But it's making room just for you. If you don't accept Jesus as your Savior, you will lift your eyes in hell. But I'm here to warn everybody that don't know Jesus for the free pardon of their sin. That we all gotta go out like CJ. One day we all gonna be stretched out here in front of the church. And the preacher gonna be saying some words over our body. And when that happens, there are no more chances. Chances are gone. The Bible says your work will follow you. If you did no kingdom work, then there would be no kingdom rewards. You know, when Jesus went away to prepare a place for us, not only that, he prepared that place for a prepared people. Are you preparing yourself today? Because we one day we're going to stand before that judge. And I heard Odin say we got to pass that solemn test. And that time make haste. It's going to be sad at the judgment. There is a name that I love to hear. This name is sweet melodies in my soul. Yeah. There is a name that saved a wretch like me. Yeah. There is a name that even caused the demons to quake. Yeah. There is a name that confuses all scholars. There is a name that spoke spinning worlds into existence. And if you don't know that name, I'm going to tell you his name, Jesus. And Jesus is made his baby. He is God, one and only potentate. And this name, Jesus, there is power in this name, Jesus. This man named Jesus, he turned water into wine. But there is a name with all power. In the strong name of Jesus, I thank you for loaning up CJ for a season. I am so thankful that he came down through our lineage. As Jesus came down through those 40 and two generations, Jesus had to be related to somebody down here on earth. And I'm glad that he was my grandson. I had to see him go, but he do tell me that there is an appointed time. We don't know when or where, but we have a time. But I'm here to say thank you. And if I were Russian, I would say Spazima. And if I were Chinese, I would say Shishir. And if I were a Vietnamese, I would say Cameroon. And if I was Swahili, I would say Asante. And if I were a Japanese, I would say Arigato. And if I was Spanish, I would say Gracious. And if I was German, I would say Dankeschön. And if I could say one word at all, I wave my hand. But here today, with my own voice, I'm going to say thank you. Thank you, Heavenly Father, for waking me up this morning. Father, I thank you for putting clothes on my back. And Father, I thank you for allowing the sun to rise when no time. And Father, I thank you, Father, that CJ brought us together on today. The Bible says, for all men work for the good. A those who love God and are called according to his purpose. You see, no matter what takes place in life, God will get the glory for it. Because people that have never prayed a sincere, serious prayer before, when this happened to CJ, y'all, they got down on their knees. And they began to call on the name of Jesus. They realized that there was salvation in the name of Jesus. And they said, Lord, what must I do to be saved? And I said, there is power in the name of Jesus. You know when Jesus walked out on that water and told Peter to come on out. But now I'm telling all of you in here today, you got to walk by faith and not by sight. It might look bad in your life, but keep on walking. You remember Jesus when he said in the scripture that if I be lifted up, then I draw all men unto me. See, Satan thought he had Jesus. They took Jesus and arrested Jesus. And they marked Jesus from judgment hall to judgment hall. And they whooped Jesus all night long. They whooped Jesus for your sins and for my sins. But Jesus never said a mumbling word. And then they marked Jesus down the Via Dolorosa, down the dusty road of Jerusalem. Jesus carried my sin on his shoulder. Jesus, he was walking. Jesus was walking. He had the cross on his shoulder. This man had did no wrong. We deserve to be crucified. We deserve to be whipped all night long. But my Jesus, he loved us so much that he bore our sins on his shoulder. But Jesus, he got to the foot of that mountain, and Jesus fell down, and they got another man to help Jesus bear that cross. was better on the cross. You know that Roman time, a cross was a commitment. Do you want to commit yourself to Christ? They marked Jesus up the hill of Golgotha. They laid it down. They spread it wide. They nailed them in his hand. They nailed riches in his feet. And Jesus said, if you think I'm going to fight, nail my hands. If you think I'm going to run, nail my feet. But Jesus, when they raised him up, between heaven and earth, the Bible say that the earth's popping real, just like a drunk man. That was God. He can't look upon sin. That's why Jesus said, why hast thou forsaken me? But they didn't know that that was the only way that man could reach salvation, is through the bloodshed of Jesus. But there is a name that's above every name. When you call on that name, Jesus, you can call on him in the wee hours of the night. He's not like you and I. He don't have a caller's ID. You know what? If somebody call us, we'll look at that phone, and we'll recognize that name, and we'll say, I'm not going to answer my phone for them. But Jesus, he said, call unto me, and I will answer you. I will show you great and wonderful things that you did not know. Oh, you can call on me in the time of trouble. You can call on me when your friends get few. You can call on me when they turn their backs on you. You remember at the cross, everybody had left except only in John. You know the Bible said that he is the disciple that Jesus loved. Jesus looked at him and said, behold thy mother. Mother, behold thy son. And the word behold, it just said, look at. Look at your mother. Look at your son. You remember when Jesus was hanging on that cross? Can you imagine the agony that his mother probably have felt? If she was a sinner, I know she would say, my son hanging on that cross. He died for you, and he died for me. That's my son that's hanging on that cross. I know your hearts are heavy, but there are no sorrows on earth where it's heaven and not here. Continue to look to the hills, from which coming all of our help. You know you'll hear some say, my father owned the cattle on a thousand hills, but my dad owned the hills also. God gives a reward to them that diligently seek him. Many times at a funeral, people don't like to open the doors of the church. But I'm never going to assume that everyone is saved. But I'm extending the invitation right now. If you don't know Jesus and the free pardon of your sin, you have a chance to do so now. While the blood is yet running warm in your veins, go down in history that I gave my life to Jesus at my cousin and my friend's funeral. CJ would be more than pleased about that. Because we all got to give up the ghost one of these days. But if you don't know Jesus, this is your time. This is your time. Just pray, just ask God to come into your heart and deliver you from your sins. And they say that if you confess with your mouth and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. Salvation is not a hard thing. People try to make it like a burden, but he wants you to come. He's standing at the doorway of your heart. He wants you to invite him into your life. Jesus will never break in on your life, but he wants you to accept him freely. While we were still yet sinners, he died for us. And hallelujah, and hallelujah, and hallelujah, your Lord of
you know the song. or two of the time of sleep. For those who die, they're at God's hand. For there's a sunrise for every soul, for life, not death is God's promise hope. So family, trust in Him, doubt in Him. Remember that it's only through dying that CJ can and will live forever. The family of Mr. Calvary and Jahari Street wishes to express their most sincere heartfelt appreciation to each of you who have been so kind to them. And thank you for the many gestures of love and sympathy that have been extended to them by way of phone calls, words of encouragement. But most of all, they thank you for praying for them. As friends, each of us can reflect upon a time when we sat just with this family to see. And it's never an easy seat to sit upon. But yet we gain strength and we are comforted because we have friends who care enough to share. Because of your presence here today and many things that you have done, this family realizes and knows that this is not their loss to bear alone. So they want to say thank you and they ask that you will continue to pray for them in the days to come. At this time, we wish to acknowledge four offering cards of condolence that have been sent for the family. With deepest sympathy, your Cordele Cobra family. Deepest sympathy to Quasia, Jeffrey, and Deborah from Davis Tax Solutions. With deepest sympathy, Kimberly Sanders and Courtney Calhoun. With love and sympathy, Wanda Byron Stokes. The Clay family. With deepest sympathy, Walmart Associates, number 1006. May the memories of the one you love and lost remain in your hearts and give you strength in the days ahead. With love and sympathy, your classmates of the class of 1983, Charlie, Sharon, Tiffany, Valeria, and William. The family flowers give you love and memory. With love, son, grandson, brother, great-grandson, nephew, cousin, and friend from the family. The love and memory of Dr. Napoleon Williams, Marcus, CEO and President, along with the staff of the J.W. Williams Funeral Home, presents to this family an African-American family heir provider. God's word is true that He will never leave you nor forsake you, so we ask that you put your trust in Him throughout this time. We're also pleased to present to this family a joint tribute of CJ's life. May you cherish all the good memories that you share together as a family.